Hey guys, Brandon here, co-founder of Life's Secret Sauce, where we teach young, motivated professionals how to fast-track their career using the skills that we should have learned in school, like communication, body language, and storytelling, rather than things like geometric proofs. I don't know about you, but I haven't used the transitive property since 10th grade, but I do know that it's all about congruency. Anyway, today we're here to talk about your hands. In particular, how much you use them or don't use them when it comes to conversation. Now, don't underestimate them. Your hands are important. They can be used for explanation, they convey trust or distrust, and I don't know how many times I've been to a cocktail hour or a networking event and people are trying to sound confident, yet their hands are fidgeting like this, or they're trying to convey trust, but their hands are shoved in their pockets. There's a lot going on with your hands and you don't want to underestimate them. Now, I'm pretty sure most people know the basics. Palms up means open, honest, approachable. Palms down, a bit more authoritative. You over there, you over there. Or you can be really authoritative and finger point. You are gonna do what I have to say. But there's a lot going on in between. So today I'm here to talk you through the 5 hand gestures that you can add to your body language repertoire today. Number 1, use your hands when talking about matters of size. You know, we have just one little problem, or we're expecting massive growth this year. I caught a fish, it was nearly this big. Now, it sounds simple, but actually employing it in a speech can have a major effect. Now, if you don't think so, try walking up to your boss and telling them that you have a big problem. It just doesn't jive right if the hand signals don't mix. Number 2, use your fingers when talking about numbers and lists. 1, 2, 3. There's the one major goal this year. We can solve this problem in 3 simple steps. Using your fingers to qualify your numbers is like bolding or underlining your text if you were writing. It just adds a little extra emphasis there. Number 3, categorization. Have you ever been talking about 2 different subjects and you can tell that you're starting to lose the other person, you know, eyes glazing over and they're not keeping track? Well, make it visually easy for people to keep track of what you're talking about. So I was going to this networking event and all the guys were over here talking about X, Y, and Z, and all the women were over here talking about A, B, and C. We went to the store and bought apples and oranges, guys and girls, bring them together. But you can use your hands to separate them out. Number 4. Showing emotion. Now this is a big one. There are times when you need to let the tenderness come through. And the one that you want to use here is the open hand, fingers spread apart, and it's the touch to the lower neck, chest area. Oh, I'm so sorry for your loss. Or, oh, it means so much to me. If you really want to get heartfelt, use this big sweeping motion right there. And then last but not least, number 5, the presidential thumbs up, which is this weird sort of half hand open, half thumbs up thing. Now this came about, watch any presidential debate or speech or presidential address in the last 40 years, and you'll find what happened was there was a shift between the finger pointing, you know, presidents can be pretty authoritative, and they said, you know, if you're trying to gain rapport and win votes from people, that's probably not the way to do it. So they came up with this like half grab, open hand thumb gesture. So the next time you're in a presentation and you find yourself about to employ the karate chop or the finger point, end up somewhere in the middle with the presidential thumbs up that way. Easy peasy. 5 simple gestures to add to your repertoire so that you know what to do with your hands other than shoving them in your pockets or wringing them nervously, or best of all, jazz hands, because those are always lots of fun. But that's all for today. I hope you got a lot of value out of this video. And if you did, click subscribe right down there in the corner and check out the link below to go visit our blog where you can get even more remarkable content to unlock your inner awesome and start fast-tracking your life. Until next time, ciao for now.